Hi, I'm Aki Watanabe, and I'm a dinosaur paleontologist working on my PhD right here at the American Museum of Natural History. So I was chosen to be a glass explorer through Google's If I Had Glass campaign. And so today I want to use Google Glass to give you an exclusive behind-the-scenes tour of my school, the Richard Gilder Graduate School, which is a school housed right inside the museum. So right now we're looking at the main entrance of the museum, which is across from the beautiful Central Park. But we can get an easy access to the school through the staff entrance, so we're going to walk over there. So while we're walking over to the staff entrance, a bit of information about the school. So the program offers PhD in comparative biology, which is a broad field of science that involves looking at the anatomy, ecology, physiology, and evolutionary history of many different groups of organisms, rather than focusing on single exemplary species, which is common in many of the other biological disciplines. So we believe that this comparative approach allows us to gain a broader and more comprehensive view about the biodiversity of the life on this planet. So the program started in 2008, and it's the first PhD granting museum in the Western Hemisphere. So it provides unique opportunities to explore and study the myriad of organisms that exist and have existed throughout Earth's long history. So we've arrived at the staff entrance on 77th Street. And the Richard Gilder Graduate School is located on the fifth floor above the public exhibits, where active research takes place. So that's the top view row of windows that you see over there. So let's go inside and begin the tour. And this is the plaque that recognizes our school.
Okay. You want to come?
Oh, that's okay.
So we're on the fifth floor of the museum. So this is where a lot of the active research takes place. So welcome to the Richard Gilder Graduate School, and this space is where the administrative offices are. And through these doors is where the offices of curators, research assistants, postdocs, and graduate students are. And also there are collections rooms where many of the 32 million specimens and artifacts are housed, and those could be used for our research. For now, we'll go to the other side and see the other parts of the school. So the hallway we're walking through right now is considered one of the longest hallways in the country, if not in the world, and it stretches an entire avenue from Central Park West to Columbus through those doors. And to my right is the mammalogy department, so you can see the tusks. And across from that is our student center. And this is a communal space for the graduate students here at the museum. And it's also where the offices of the first year graduate students are. So it's a nice space. We got a nice big TV, comfortable couches, and here we have some archosaurs, which is a group that is composed of alligators, crocodiles, and dinosaurs, and their close relatives. And as an added bonus, we get a nice view of Manhattan So right now this room is a bit empty because a lot of the students are actually out of the country for field work. Field work is a big component of the program. So for example, Bernardo here is in Brazil right now. And Jenny, who sits right there at that desk, is in Madagascar. And Lauren, who used to sit at that desk, is in New Guinea. And up there, we have some computers for running long analyses, for example. And this space is also used for inviting researchers from all around the world. So we have guest speakers, and we often invite them into this room to interact with the graduate students. So it's a great place to have discussions and for on scientific questions and research. And also it could be a place for potential collaborative work. Here we have our teaching lab room where we have the lab sessions for courses offered here at the Richard Gilder School. So the curators are certified professors, and they're often adjunct professors at nearby institutions. So they are instructors for many of the courses offered here at the museum. And graduate students from other universities could take the courses here, and vice versa. As a student of the Richard Gilder School, if we want to take a class, let's say at Columbia, we could easily do that because we have good relationship with nearby universities. So although we have this really nice lab space, for some of the classes, the lab session is held elsewhere. So for a good example of that is the course I took this spring, Reptile Biology, where we had the lab session in the herpetology department with all the specimens. And I know my friends who took next-gen sequencing course had their labs in the Sackler Institute for Comparative Genomics, which is on top of the museum. Through those doors is the anthropology department, but we're going to take a left turn here to visit the last room that makes up the Richard Gilder Graduate School. So here's our lecture hall, and this is where we have lectures for many of the courses that are offered at the museum. It also is a place where we have our weekly comparative biology seminar series, where we have researchers from around the world talk about their research, which is followed by Q&A session and discussions. So as you can see, the museum is not only a great place to come and learn the natural history of the world, but also a place for active research that moves the field of biology forward. So I'll end this tour with a view of Central Park in Manhattan from up here. And down there is where we started this tour. And if you're interested in learning more about the program, please visit rggs.amnh.org, especially if you're interested in applying for the program. And with that, I hope you enjoyed this tour of the Richard Gilder Graduate School. And I hope to see many of you in the exhibits or in the program in the near future. Thanks for watching.